Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. I hope you're doing all fine. So before we start, as usual, I'm not a financial advisor, and all the content and information in this video is my own opinion and my own market observation. So let's dive here into the 4 hours chart. Since we broke out of this rising wedge to the downside, we are trading here in this channel with a clear straight support and a clear straight resistance line. It seems like we are breaking out now to the upside, but it's not yet confirmed, so we may be gonna stay a little more while in this area here. But as you can see, we are still trading inside this main channel here with the support around 5,200 and the resistance at around 5,800. So right now, I still expect the price that can drop to around 5,200 or 50, or can go up to 5,800. If 5,800 is broken, I think 6.2K is the target, and if we break here 5,200, probably 4,800 will be the target at around this line here. So we have to keep an eye on these two main support and resistance lines. But as long as we don't break any of them, I think that we're going up and down here for quite some time. And even if we had this correction right now, there is a still high chance that we can still go further up. Also, what I want to point out is that the shorts right now are rising up again dramatically. So as you can see, we already surpassed the long positions, so the shorts are spiking up like crazy. And if this continue like that, I think if we see a push to the upside, this will give the bulls even more fire to the upside, because all the short positions will get liquidated and stopped out. So this will help the bulls even more to push to the upside. So what I want to look at next is what is going on here with the RSI and also the stochastic RSI. Let's start here with the weekly, because here in the weekly, as you can see, we just crossed the 20 weekly moving average. So if we can close, I'm sorry, we are in the monthly. So this is the 20 monthly moving average. So if we can close this monthly candle above 5,200, let's say 5,300, is almost 5,300, I think this line will act then as a support line, and this will be very, very bullish if we can close above 5,300. But if we're gonna get rejected here and we're gonna trade again next month below this line here, I think this line will become resistance, and maybe a further correction is in the cards. But as long as we stay above, I think this can be very, very bullish. Also, in the last bull market, this line acted as a support, and as soon as we broke to the downside from this line here, we were trading below this line, and we never tested. So now it can act as a resistance, but it's not yet confirmed. So we have to see what's going on here and how we're gonna close this month. Let's go here to the weekly, because this is the most important here right now, because here we have a stochastic RSI that is very overbought since weeks now. And also the RSI is moving towards the 70 level, which is overbought condition. We're not yet there, but we are very close. Also here you can see the 20 weekly moving average that is acting as a resistance. We had a little spike to the upside, but as you can see, we're trading again just at the line here. So I think here this line could act as a resistance, and if so, we have to be prepared for a retest maybe of the 50 weekly moving average at 4,500, and if this doesn't hold, maybe the 200 weekly moving average as at around 3,500. And this, in my opinion, is a target that we really should consider, that could come in the maybe not so close future, but could come before Bitcoin goes into a real bull run that beats the all-time high of 20K. So let's move on to the daily chart. Here as well, we are overbought in the RSI since a very long time. A stochastic RSI just bottomed and is now on the way up. So here also, I think we are on the way that maybe we can see a correction and a retest of one of these lines. Even we had this golden cross, it's not yet confirmed. We have to touch and get support at least the 200 daily moving average, at least this line here. This is the most important. Hopefully the 50 daily moving average will have support, or even the 20, but the red line here is the most important, that we stay above this line. So we have to stay above $4,500. All right, so this is for the big picture, and I think as long as 4,500 is held, we should be good. Here in the 4 hours, in the stochastic, we are oversold, and also the RSI is moving around the 50, so that means that we could see some more pushes to the upside in the next couple of hours. Let's see the hourly time frame. What do we have here? Yeah, here in the stochastic, we are overbought right now, and the RSI is for close to the 50. So even here, we could see maybe the price continue to move to the upside, even if the stochastic is in overbought, but we can maybe stay a bit up here till the RSI also get in overbought territory. Yeah, but this is a small time frames. I'm not watching that much. If I trade, if I do daily trade, I just look at 1 minute, 5 minute, and 30 minutes chart here, trading when we are overbought or oversold for day trades. But for the big picture, I think that we maybe can see some more pushes to the upside before a possible correction. And if we see a correction, keep an eye on the daily chart. Yeah, it's not loading, so never mind. But you saw it before, which lines you should look at. All right, guys. So before I'm gonna wrap it up for today, I just want to tell you that in my video description, if you go down here, you have all the links how to get some free Bitcoin, some free XRP, and so on. And what I added right now is the new decentralized Brave browser with an integrated ad blocker. It works similar like Google Chrome, so it's something similar. But the good thing about this is of course that it's decentralized, but also you get rewarded with the BAT token when you watch ads, or you do comments or whatever. There's many things you can get BAT token, but the thing is that BAT token you can trade also on Coinbase and Binance in many exchanges. You can keep it or you can sell it for Bitcoin. So it is like it's like you're using the normal internet instead of Chrome, using the browser of Brave, and you get rewarded with this back. So why not? I tried this out and it works perfectly, and I think that it's even faster than Chrome sometimes. And if you use my link to install it, you will be forwarded to the main website where you can download the browser, and you get how much you get. I don't know exactly how much you get, but something like free BAT token, like 10 BATs or like $10 worth of BAT, something like that, if you use my link. Otherwise, you can go through the main page and download it, but you don't get any free coins. I think that's it. That's a good thing to do if you want to try it out. Yeah. All right, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up for now. I hope you're in a good trade, and see you all in the next one. Bye.